your WCBI First Alert AccuWeather forecast with meteorologist Alex Puckett.
Well, sort of a gloomy look to the start of our Monday afternoon. We're dealing with overcast skies pretty much area-wide, temperatures in the 50s and 60s, so certainly doesn't feel like strong to severe storms would be possible this evening, but that is going to be the case. It looks like we may see some sunshine today before all is said and done. We've seen some clouds break up. You see back to our west thunderstorms starting to organize back into Arkansas. We'll be keeping an eye on those. As for the rest of the day today, we expect temperatures to climb into the 70s, so we do expect a warm-up as we head through the rest of the afternoon. Now, as we head into the evening, here's the ingredients that are sort of coming into place, the chance for some severe thunderstorms. Dew points up into the 60s, up to around 70, so we do expect to have enough moisture in place at the surface to support severe storms. We've got that cold front crashing in from the north and west, so that's going to give us plenty of lift, as well as an upper-level system, so we'll check that off as well. Unlike Thursday morning storm of last week, these storms are going to have a little bit more unstable air to work with. So the instability is going to be in place to support severe thunderstorms. There's going to be some question here as to how well this is going to support tornadoes, but we definitely have enough at least to support severe weather and enough wind shear to support all modes of severe weather as well. So here is our thinking with this setup. Here's the future cast. We'll start to see some thunderstorms move in as early as 6 p.m. I say as early because the main line of storms will still be back off to our west, but we could see some stuff develop out ahead of that main line. So storms like this one showing up on the future cast, if these do come to fruition, would have an enhanced tornado threat with them. We have that main line of broken thunderstorms that'll push through later on this evening. Main time frame for severe weather, probably from about 9 p.m. to 3 a.m., but it could occur at any time between 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. with this setup. So here's our thinking as far as the threats with this. Damaging straight-line winds is going to be the biggest threat. We're most confident in that threat. Having said that, with the wind shear we have in place, we do have enough wind shear and enough instability to support a few tornadoes, and I'm not going to rule out an isolated strong tornado. That means an EF2 or stronger tornado, so that's something we'll be keeping an eye on overnight. Hail, not a big threat. We could see some small hail, maybe one or two storms producing hail up to the size of a quarter, but that certainly looks like a secondary threat with this setup. The good news, I don't expect to many issues tomorrow, so as you head to the polls, weather looks okay for that. No widespread issues there. So here's how the next 7 days is going to work out. Again, Election Day, maybe a lingering shower in the morning by the time the polls open, but no big issues. Temperatures in the 50s and 60s through the rest of the work week. Some lingering showers, but sunshine returns by this weekend. More midday after this.